Hello friends. In this video, I will teach you bone dynamics in Moho. In Moho, bone dynamics allow you to automatically add secondary animation and follow through to your characters, giving you control over how you want things to move. Wind dynamics is a new way to take control over the strength, direction, and turbulence of wind and make your scenes come alive in minutes. Pay attention to the movement of the antenna on the car. The movement of the antenna follows the movement of the car and helps the animation to be alive. All this is with the help of bone dynamics, which I will teach you in the rest of this video. First, I imported a photo of a car. I create a bone layer for the car and put the photo of the car inside the bone layer. I make a bone for the car. I create a new vector layer and draw an antenna for the car with the shape tool. I will add one point to correct the shape of the antenna. I create 4 points for the antenna with the add point tool. I add these points in the parts where I want the antenna to bend. I write the name of this layer as antenna and put it inside the bone layer. I click on the antenna layer and draw two lines next to the points. These are the guidelines to measure the bones to the points on the line. After finishing the work, I erase the guidelines. I click on the bone layer and create 3 bones with the add bone tool. Now I erase the guidelines. I bind the bones to the points. First, I click on the bone layer. I select the first bone and then click on the antenna layer. I select 2 points and activate the bind point tool. And finally, I click on the bind point button. So that the movement of this bone is connected to these points. I click again on the bone layer and select the next bone. And I repeat the same thing. I select 2 higher points and bind them. I click again on the bone layer, select the next bone and bind it to the top 3 points. I click on the bone layer, select 3 bones and set the bone strength to 0 with the bone strength tool and drag. I also set the power of the car to 0. I check the connection of the bones with the reparent tool, which you can see is done correctly. You can modify the connection of the bones with the reparent tool and clicking. I select the antenna and put it in the right place with the transform tool. I select the bone layer and put the bones on the antenna with the transfer tool. Now select the first bone and activate the dynamic bone option in the bone constraints section. In the boxes below, we can determine the amount of antenna movement. For this bone, I consider the numbers 2 to 2 and 1, respectively. I select the second bone and activate bone dynamics again. I consider the number 1 in each of the boxes. Again with the select bone tool, I select the third bone. I activate the dynamic bone and consider the number 1 for every 3 boxes. Now I click on the bone layer and create movement for the car. I put the car outside the frame with the transform tool. I click on frame 1 to create a keyframe. I put the slider in frame 48 and move the car forward by holding the shift button. And in frame 72, I also move the car back a little. I press the play button. You can see that the movement of the antenna is done well and is naturally coordinated with the movement of the car. You can use this technique in different projects. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.